joins us. Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you.
Morning.
My pleasure.
I would bet there's very few people who could say they were married to a prime minister and the mother of a prime minister.
Your president, that wonderful Barbara Bush, your first lady.
Ah, sure.
She had a son and a husband in your White House, and I have the same. Very small, we're a tenth of the size of you.
So when you married Pierre Trudeau, you were in your early 20s.
I was.
And tell us what that experience was like, because from what I'm reading about you, you were kind of out doing your own thing, and you were considered
totally free spirit. I think that was one of the charms that Pierre chose me for, and then he tried to put me in an ivory tower and cut me off from everything, and it was all protocol and all very stuffy then, really. So many rules.
Didn't you kind of know that was coming, what you were getting yourself into?
You know what? I nothing could prepare you. One of the lines in my play is the five reasons that being a prime minister's wife prepares you to be in a psychiatric ward. Because I have been there as well, at both places.
And, you would talk
both keeping you in place.
You hinted on talking about mental illness.
Yes.
You talk very openly about your struggles.
I'm a mental health advocate, yes.
So how did it come about? I know we talk about your early days when you were young. Do you think that's something you've been struggling with your whole life?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, and like so many people who I suffer bipolar.
Uh-huh.
And like so many people who do suffer bipolar, it really raises its head in your late teens, early 20s. There's a lot of teenage angst that goes on before that, you know, just willful teenagers. Mm-hmm. It's hard to determine whether this is a mental illness or this is just being a teenager.
Yeah.
Right.
I say part of being bipolar when I was untreated was I was a perpetual teenager.
Yeah.
You keep very young.
And at this time, you're at Studio 54, mixing with celebrities and dating with celebrities. What was that like at
that time? Well, I was studying acting in New York. I had broken free from my marriage, but I still was mummy to my three sons with my husband. So I was 2 weeks in New York studying acting and 2 weeks up in Canada taking care of the children. So it was kind of a very dichotomized life. Studio 54 was to work out because I like to dance.
It was to work out. Do you have any good stories from those days?
Oh my goodness, so many. And my
book
Changing My Mind. Though that was an exciting part of my life, but it was also a part of my life where I was suffering from a mental illness and I didn't understand it. I didn't know what was happening to me. I didn't understand these high highs and then these terrible lows and not finding balance. Peace of mind. So it was the beginning, really, of my journey of trying to figure out who was I and what was wrong. It took some time because one of the biggest things after you get a diagnosis of mental illness, your first reaction is denial. Oh no, you're wrong.
Yeah.
Because it's a hard thing to take on. There's such a stigma against mental illness. What I've been trying to do is just normalize it. It can hit anyone at any time. It's another part of our human condition and a big one. And if we can't get hold of our mental illness, be mentally well, how are we going to survive? How are we going to live our lives?
So, if you have a cell phone right now and we called your son, the Prime Minister of Canada, would he pick up the phone and talk to us?
Well, I'd have to text him first. There is a way.
There is a...
Are you free to chat, honey pie?
You must be so proud of him.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my children. But Justin is an exceptional boy, a man. I keep forgetting that he's a grown-up. We tend to keep our children young forever, don't we?
Do you talk about him in your one-woman show, or is it mostly about your journey?
Oh, yes. Yes, he's in there, as are my other children. It's a journey that... It's fun, because it's a way awakening of a feminist, which I certainly am after all my struggles trying to find where a woman's place is in life. One of the lines I like so much is that I don't even believe technically in the equality of men and women, because of course we're superior.
Well, that's all the time we have. You can see Margaret Trudeau's show, Certain Woman of an Age, May 9th through the 12th at the Up Comedy Club on North Avenue. Go to secondcity.com for more information.
Pleasure to meet you.
Thanks
nice
for
to
being
meet
here.
You.
Thank you, Larry.